Yes, team, we are back on the YouTube episodes, Ground Zero. This week, we're going to be showcasing what it is to be a functional bodybuilder here at the Trainer Club. We need to be ready to turn our hands to anything and everything. The competition season is underway and full throttle at that. There's dates dotted all around the year, around the schedule. Next week is the Birmingham Hyrox. So today, we're going to be filming across 2 days. So today, we're going to be capturing some Hyrox style sort of accessory work. And then tomorrow we're going to go into a signature TC build session. So I'm going to get warmed up now, I'm going to get ready to go, and then I'm going to sink our teeth into some nasty, nasty work. Let's go. Today's workout is as follows. Ignore this. This has been set by Harrison, who's been working on a little bit of a Hyrox add-on, so to speak, to run alongside what we do in-house in our build sessions. If you didn't already, Hyrox is pretty much working under fatigue, running under fatigue. So today that's what I'm going to expose myself to. I've got a 30-minute AMRAP. This will be one of two sessions today for myself. So we're going to hit a 400-meter run, followed by 25 wall balls, 400-meter run, 25 lunges, 250-meter ski, 25 wall balls. So all the movements that come up and crop up in Hyrox. And again, just exposing myself to running and working under fatigue, basically. It's going to be tasty.
Hey, I got the recipe, never gonna let any op get the best of me. Thought it was distance, but haters is next to me. Talk to the spirit, you know I've been heavenly. Company definitely show your trajectory. This ain't a diss cause I say it respectfully. It's time to eat up, bread like a speeder. Taking it deeper and that's how it better be. I never let the comparison get to me. I just remember the promises meant for me. I know the enemy and that he sent for me. I keep the blood of the lamb as my centerpiece. I cannot trust in no crystals or energy. Look at the chemistry, it do not even mix chemically. Most of the tricks, they be gimmicks, they mimic the truth. It's poison and we got the remedy. There is a bomb, apply it.
Ain't never lacking it, so what I'm packing, he taking it, he magnifying it.
They say you ain't about it. Tell them that you finna make it, but they doubt it. But you rose like the flower. Tell me what it's like to live with superpowers.
I don't know, but I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I just know that I'ma get it. 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 Ayy, I got the drive, the bus, the truck, the gas is stuck. I ain't the one to rely on the luck. I put in work and then he show up. I know it's faith that's in the reps. Ain't no regrets, I do too much. It ain't me if you saying I stunt. He calling the plays and I do what he want. This ain't a front, glory to G-O-D. It's what you could do with a mustard seed. It's what you could do when you start to believe. Take fear and you cast it inside of the sea. 100% out of me, cause he gave it all on the tee when he let it bleed. So what is you saying to me? You just insecure about the love that turned me to a beast. I take a step and I ain't turning back. He made me first cause I know that I'm last. I ain't got time for no thing in the past. Learn from it first and then I react. Hands off me, don't hold me. Get it jumping like a trampoline. All truth ain't no trolling. We in good hands, no folding.
They say you ain't about it. Tell them that you finna make it, but they doubt it.
But God did it.
But you rose like a flower. Tell me what it's like to live with superpowers.
I don't know, but I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I just know that I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I'ma get it. I'ma get it.
Fuck you. Oh. There we have it. Hyrox accessory. The run's obviously the hardest part. That's meant to be a recovery. I always, when I'm training, I always try to stay sub 4:30. I think after the second round, it crept up there. I think I've seen 6 minutes at one point, but we sharp got it back down. It's just pure lactic acid in the quads. I think especially after Monday. Monday's our low body day in house, so the DOMS are always real on a Wednesday. The clock kept me accountable. The demons creep in. But if you let them creep in a session like this, when it's not competition day, and they go and get stuff on comp day, 9 times out of 10 you're going to resonate with that person who give up. So no matter what, you just got to keep going. And one of our company values is tenacity in all things that you do, whether it's your cleaning, your coaching, your admin, your training. When the going gets tough, operate as if someone's always watching you. And I think that's a good value to live by. Something I try to live by, and something I think the boys are really adopting and do live by themselves, so. Pretty sick. Fuck now, like. Game over. Daisy eyes.
Why it just resonated with me primarily was down to the idea that when we're speaking about what the training club creates as a byproduct for individuals, it's not necessarily like the physique transformation. Yes, it's like something that comes alongside that. However, everything that they get through the entire process of coming into the TC, let it be their training, their understanding of nutrition, or better understanding through habits and behaviour change, that in itself is more exciting and something that is more impactful. Like speaking about the journey instead of necessarily the, as you said, like the 12 week let's get shredded as fuck transformation kind of brand. Like, we are the people who change the lives of men better than in many aspects of their lives and create this safe haven for themselves to therefore go out and do even better outside of that.
And going through my own journey myself, I think I'm a lot happier myself, as are a lot of members I work with, who will be more based upon that approach and, you know, working on themselves, working on little bits of cardio, improving the steps, getting out, just working on themselves, more self-development rather than just thinking, right, let's cut calories and let's feel horrendous for 12 weeks. Why don't we feel good for a longer period of time and notice the results, as Sammy said, as part of that process. Mm-hmm. And then feeling like you're more ingrained within that culture from part of that rather than just feeling like you have to do 12 weeks and then, right, what do I work on now?
Yeah.
It can be that continuous work in progress as well, which is, it's I think it's more exciting, personally.
Yeah. I want people to aspire to be here as a member, where it's not like a, oh, I'll just come here for 3 months and fucking off. Do you know what I mean? Like, you want coaches to be fucking wanting to wear your badge of pride and work here, and which we do. The most recent feel of that is him, like, all you want to do is work here, mint. And then the same with members, like, you want them to, do you know what I mean? Like, be wired to be at the training club. Like, that's fucking sick. And I think that's the thing that we have diluted and lost a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is a huge deal for
you. Right, so. No fucking straps.
No straps?
No straps. I made sure everyone knew that as well. No straps. 85% of the 3 rep max times 5. Cool. Chest supported row, hamstring curl. Interesting. Tasty one.
Second day of filming YouTube. Today we're going to be hitting the online build session, programmed by Marcus and Harrison. It's the second week, I believe, of the actual program following a testing week. Yes, we did testing, did week one last week, yeah, the second week of the program. So today I'm just going to look to move well and see if I can build on last week's lifts. The What Up app that we use for our online program keeps me right every week, allows me to come into the session knowing exactly what I'm doing and knowing exactly what I lifted the week before, which is something that I've never really seen the beauty of, I guess, but I've been forced to kind of look into this program and practice what we preach, and it's definitely paying off because I can feel the benefits of it already. So it's gonna be a good session. So today's main KPI is going to be the barbell deadlift. Okay, we're pulling from the floor. I'm not going to lie, I'm feeling a bit stiff around the hip area, so I've done some extra mobility there, but a little bit off plan in terms of my prep and prime, which is something that we always do before even the HQ sessions and the online. So my prep and prime today was a little bit mobility around the hips,
hips and glutes, because they absolutely trashed up yesterday. And then I went in, what I try to do is I warm up the lat, core, oblique sling, trunk, that whole sort of area. And we did some single arm suitcase kettlebell deadlifts, and then went into some side bends. What else have we done? I always like to superset my warm-up sets on the bar with something explosive as well. So I'll probably just go into some counter movement jumps. It's something I feel like I've always done when I used to play sport. And still do even now. Every time I go into a heavy set, I always like, I just feel like it wakes me up and gets everything firing, and I feel good for doing so. So I'll be doing that. First set has been, 70 kilos. And we'll just build it up. My testing score on the testing week was 183. That's my 3 rep max. So I believe today's work is 85% of that 3 rep max for 5. And then we're going to do 2 sets of 3 for 90%. And then the last set is going to be back to 85% of that 3 rep max. You're going to go for as many reps as possible, above 3 at least. And you're going to cap it at 10. And then if you hit 10 this week, next week you know you need to slightly increase your load. Let's go. A little tip for me when you're warming up is approach your warm-up set and your lighter loads the same way you would approach your biggest lift. So you set up, set the standard, set the pyramid from the off, move with intensity, move with purpose, and move at the same speed and power and generate the same force that you would if you were going to be hitting your heavier set. So I might ramp that up a little bit today. I'll see how I feel. I'm gonna get the bar to 150 now. Big jump, it is a big jump, but I feel really good. I feel warm. 110, 150. And the next up we weren't set. Last of the warm. As I get closer to the working set, I don't normally like to fatigue myself too much, and I'll just kind of feel the weight. I felt fucking heavy. Have I calculated that wrong? Yeah, have you not? Have I not? What a fucking donut. Amateur. 110, I got 120. 25, there we go. Wishes he was in, don't you, mate? Jealous?
I'm in, I wish I was in.
So, what you see in my hand, ladies and gentlemen, is what we call the Persian Power Shake. Now, the Persian Power Shake is 1,000 calories of pure greatness. We've got banana, peanut butter, protein, creatine. What else have we got in here? Honey. Everything that you need to be anabolic as fuck.
You love the YouTube, man. That's all it is, get him in. Give him a wave, you can see himself. Yo, what's the voice So we've just established we're having some technical difficulties with loading the bar. It seems that I've got nervous on camera and I've misjudged my lift by about 20 kilos. So I should be lifting 152.5. And I bigged up the app at the beginning saying that it tells me exactly what I should be doing, but I've fucking duffed it. Fucked it. The job's fucked. So I'm at 175.3. This is going to be my third set of that weight. I'm just calling it a day there. Legs and hips are in the trash can of this entire office.
Trash can.
Trash can.
Trash can. American.
I come from the streets where they kill scrap. This AK got so many bodies, I call it charge. We was trying to find the lick, y'all niggas was throwing down. Keep them young niggas still have respect when they was broke. That shit full of weirdos.
One of the biggest things when it comes to hypertrophy and growing tissue is create stability. It's one of the most overlooked things I personally feel. So that's the reason this bench is here now. So I can press my whole body weight against it, therefore lift heavier loads, therefore challenge my muscle tissue a lot better. And then obviously the execution counts as well. That's why obviously we do what we do in here as personal trainers. We make sure every person leaves like they've had a one-to-one PT session, and then how we transfer that same sort of detail and standard onto the online program is every single exercise has like a coach's corner and a demonstration video and a written description of how it should look. The guys can send in their videos and have them reviewed by a coach as well, and we'll just kind of give them little tweaks and stuff. So yeah, the aim is always quality. And like I say, if you're looking to build tissue, stability is one of the most important things. And then obviously finding intensity within the set, challenging the muscle adequately. Pointless training like fairy, funny, I'm not going to say that. You're not actually going to achieve this. So don't be afraid to get nasty, make the muscle hurt, basically. Next set, the warm-up set one. Three to do now, three working sets. Probably more for around 50. I feel like if I go any heavier than that, I can't create that sort of scoop feeling, that scoop motion that I want. And I'll start using my bicep and rounding up a little bit, so. Here we go. Set one, 10 reps. Set up, forearm against the bench. I'm going to stretch my leg out a little bit so I've got that elbow path. And then from there, I'm going to supinate my hand a little bit. I'm going to retract shoulder. And then the aim here is to scoop with the elbow round and follow the line of the lat, and then look to challenge that.
You have to eat the dream, you have to sleep the dream, you have to dream the dream, you gotta touch, you have to see it when nobody else sees it, you have to feel it when it's gone from there to the back.
Something I'm always thinking when I'm executing movements in a bodybuilding manner is own every single part of the rep. The skill element of hypertrophy is one of the hardest things. Everyone can shift in, move in a certain way, I get it. Whilst there's absolutely nothing wrong with that, I like to try and take it a little bit further, as I'm someone who's like well trained, so to speak, over the years. And I like to try and put my knowledge to the test for myself almost as well. So yeah. second half. I normally like to have about 30 seconds between each arm as well, so I'm training each lat, each leg, which is like a full game split squat or whatever. Like, as its own thing, identity, so to speak. If you're doing it right, shit's intense. Two more weapon sets to go. This part of our session that we're looking to build and challenge and tear tissue, so to speak, so we can grow it, is the slowest part of the session, but the intensity is in the work that you do, in the execution. It's not a fucking hit class, not a certain class. You need to do the work, focus on what we're trying to achieve, put some intent on the muscle that we're trying to work. Something we're very big on here. It's choosing when it's go time, when we're prescribing capacity work to build an engine, when we're bodybuilding, when we're lifting for strength. Trying to create that all-rounder. That's what it's all about here. The term functional bodybuilding gets thrown around quite a lot, loosely I feel. Like, what is that? So what it is, just being able to turn your hand to every sort of, be adapted to every situation. Take from your way. We've got lads who train like this but can turn their hand to Hyrox because of the stuff that we do within the program. We've got people who turn their hand to Apex. We've got people who are just strictly kind of follow a bodybuilding sort of split, which is absolutely fine. I'd say the core group of our membership and our members can pretty much turn their hand to anything that comes their way, which is pretty sick. It's always been the aim.
Yesterday and today, give you a little insight to the trim that I'll be doing on build up to Hyrox. So as I said, when we start the YouTube, the week consists of track sessions, accessory sort of Hyrox sessions in the gym, running under fatigue with the movements that will come up on the day, lunges, ski. The only thing I haven't exposed myself to much, which I need to, is the prowler. However, I'm pretty confident on that, and when it comes to the day, I'm normally okay. And then obviously today we've gone into more of the build slash or bodybuilding style of sessions that we do here at the training club. And I was obviously doing the build online program, which is something that we've been really, really focused on the last few weeks. And as I've said again on previous videos, the community has grown exponentially, which I'm very happy about. And then as we come closer to Hyrox, because I think we're about, what are we, eight days out from Birmingham. Our week next week, training wise, I guess won't really look much different, to be honest. I think I'll probably hang back with the intensity and the volume on the build strength session in terms of the lower body, which is normally on a Monday. But the way we're going at the minute, I'll be honest, I am getting quite a bit of DOMS from those workouts. I'll probably hang back a little bit with them and literally just do as if it was a sport specific stuff, really, I guess, for Hyrox on the day. I'll treat the Saturday as my match day, in football terms, and then I'll just do what I'd normally do, I guess, throughout the week. Keep nutrition the same. The only thing I normally do the night before is I'll reduce my protein a little bit and finish eating like a little bit earlier than I normally do. Normally by the time I get back from work from here, I'm eating quite late, which I don't like to do, because as I've said before, I hate waking up feeling bloated. But
Yeah, I think our kick-off time on the Saturdays are normally around when we do the men's doubles. It's about 10 past 8, half 8. So yeah, night before, reduce protein because you don't want to be feeling heavy on the morning. And then the morning of, I'll just have a light carb meal, I guess. And some electrolytes. Something I've had a problem with, actually, for transparency, is been getting cramped by the time we get to like round 7, I think it is, or the farmers carry around that kind of area. For whatever reason, every single time I've done Hyrox, I seem to cramp up at that point, which is strange. I haven't cramped up yet in training, and it's probably the most I've trained for the Hyrox comp, so I'm hoping on the day, feeling right, should be fine. But yeah, I'm excited to throw down my bottle. The aim is sub 60, lots of pressure on us. We're seeing that on camera. We'll see how we get on. Right guys, that's a wrap on episode 4 of this YouTube series, Ground Zero. We give you a little insight to the training in preparation for Hyrox next week at Birmingham, and a little insight to our core product here at the training club with the online build. If you want a sample and like what you see with regards to the training product, then hit the link in the description below. You'll be able to get a free week of training on us, in which you can sample it, join the team. It'll be unbelievable to have you join our community. I guess if you're enjoying what we're doing, what we're pushing out, like, follow, subscribe, and I'll see you at the next one. I'm just gonna go and watch the HQ session now and see how the boys are getting on.
Recipe, never gonna let any op be the best of me. Thought it was distance, but haters is next to me. Talk to the spirit, you know I've been heavenly. Company definitely show your trajectory. This ain't a diss cause I say it respectfully. It's time to eat up, bread like a speeder. Taking it deeper and that's how it better be. I never let the comparison get to me. I just remember the promises meant for me. I know the enemy and that he sent for me. I keep the blood of the lambs my centerpiece.